have been killed in Bihar. Tremors have been felt across the east and north of the country. The army, meanwhile, has been pressed into service along with the Indian Air Force. Five planes are, even as we speak, on their way to Sikkim. Many roads have been blocked in Sikkim due to massive landslides which were triggered by the massive earthquake. The Indo-Tibetan Border Police has launched a search and rescue operations in the Pegong area of North Sikkim, which has been badly affected, with two ITBP buildings also collapsing after the state was rocked by the powerful earthquake. Official sources are now saying that search and rescue operations are getting hampered because there is no electricity in the area.
Several people dead, an unspecified number injured, dozens of buildings damaged, and many roads blocked by mudslides triggered off by the high-intensity quake. 6.8 on the Richter scale, this has been the biggest earthquake in Sikkim since 1950, a fact confirmed by the state's chief secretary, Mr. Karma Gyatso. Two plane loads of National Disaster Response Team have already landed in Bagdogra, and they are being rushed to the worst hit parts of Sikkim in a couple of hours' time. Already, police, paramilitary and personnel of the local disaster management team and civil defense personnel are out looking for survivors under the debris. In fact, the exact extent of the damage or the devastation will be known only in a couple of hours' time when rescuers reach the remote and far-flung areas of Sikkim. Wasbir Hussain, Times Now.
You already know about the earthquake which took place. It had the intensity of 6.8 on the Richter scale, and there were two aftershocks. And the aftershocks were also fairly intense. One was 5.8 on the Richter scale. Now, the National Crisis Management Team is meeting. In fact, I'm in meeting just now. And on the part of the central government, we are going to do our utmost to help in this event. Now, what we have done is we have immediately mobilized and made arrangements for two aircraft to fly from Hindon to Bagdogra with four teams of the NDRF with all equipment. We are also arranging for one aircraft to fly from Palam to Bagdogra, and an empty aircraft will go from Agra to Calcutta, and from Calcutta it's going to mobilize additional teams of the NDRF which will be flown to Bagdogra, and we are making arrangements for night landing at Bagdogra. We are, I think, somewhat close in terms of time, close to the event, so as time passes it is likely that we might get more information and confirmed information about damage to property or casualties or any unfortunate deaths. The army is going to help and helping whatever they can. So all that has been tied up. The army, the Border Roads Organization, the National Defence Relief Force. So everyone is pressed into service, and we are going to do our utmost to help out in this event.
Let's also tell you what happened right from the start. The first reports came in at about 6:15 of tremors being felt across north and east of India. The epicenter of the earthquake, measuring 6.8 on the Richter scale, is Sikkim. And even as we speak, the magnitude of the impact of the earthquake is still being assessed.
First thing that you notice when you feel the jolt of a quake: a fan swinging, light bulb shaking.
Magnitude of this earthquake is 6.8. The location is India, Sikkim, Nepal border, and time is 6:11 PM.
With an epicenter along the Sikkim-Nepal border, the quake measuring 6.8 on the Richter scale jolted the entire north and northeast belt.
Where we are right now in the national capital, tremors were felt at about 6:11 p.m. in the evening, which lasted for about 15 to 20 seconds. A lot of people, because of the fear factor and anxiety, came out of their residences and gathered on the road.
आज का टीवी देख रहे थे, एक सोफा हिलने लगा, हम लोग उठ के भागने भागे, तले खत्म हो गया.
People here in Guwahati ran out of their homes in panic and stayed on the roads as the tremors lasted for 10 to 15 seconds. and feared to go back to their homes, fearing that there might be aftershocks.
मैं तो मेरा पिताजी मामी के साथ बैठ के चाय पी रहे थे हम लोग गप कर रहे थे अचानक इतना जोर शेक हुआ मेरा जिंदगी में तो मैं ऐसा शेक कभी नहीं देखा
Apart from that, many people also did manage to run out of their houses. What we hear is that in North Bengal, in Siliguri, there were tremors felt very strongly over there. In fact, cracks in many buildings.
In the same floor, in the seventh floor, I ran to my grandfather to make sure he was safe or not. Yeah, that's it. And it was like for a minute or so, and it was really shaky.
Cities closer to the epicenter feeling the pinch. Seismologists confirming that north of India will always remain vulnerable. To quakes. An urgent need to refurbish our disaster management. With Bureau Inputs, Muralidharan for Times Now.
And in Nepal, where damage has also been extensive, at least 5 people have been killed due to the earthquake. 3 of them were killed when a high brick wall of the British Embassy collapsed. A man and his daughter and another pedestrian died after the wall of the embassy collapsed right on them.
Yeah, the information that we've got, I mean, like this was the same time, 6:26 Nepali time, that is 6:11 Indian time in the evening. And at least 5 people have lost their life, 3 in Kathmandu, when the British Embassy compound wall fell on them, you know, and 2 in Eastern Nepal, Sunsari district. So the more, you know, like reports are yet to come, but they have been... Extensive damage of houses, you know, like people have been wounded, about 2 dozen people. So that's the information we have, but it's very preliminary. No, I mean, like, so far nothing. Because they are still assessing the damage, there is, you know, like, you don't have natural disaster sale, okay, you know, this in government here. I mean, except what happened, we don't have anything. Government hasn't said anything.
Take a very short break. Coming up next, for those having suffered the 2002 Gujarat riots, their march today was stopped by the Modi government, even as they wrote an open letter to the Chief Minister demanding justice.